Metro Manila transitions to general community quarantine starting June 1st, that's Monday, following a 2.5-month lockdown. This means almost all industries will now be allowed to restart except for leisure and amusement services. Question is, are we ready or are we flirting with what could potentially be a more severe wave of infections that could break our healthcare system? Joining us today, Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship Joy Concepcion and former Health Secretary Janet Carrion, Program Leader of Project ARC. She's also Iloilo First District Congresswoman. Hi, Sir Joey and Congresswoman Janet. Thank you for joining us this afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. So I guess let's start with this. Joey, are we flattening the curve? I mean, the whole point of the lockdown is not really to change the outcome, but to delay it so the healthcare system can cope. Are we? I mean, we're opening on Monday. Are we successful?
Yes, yes. The way I look at it is that basically the five resets has given enough time for the government to really prepare with all the quarantine centers. The testing capacity has improved now to about 8,000 to 11,000. I think Janet Garin can explain more of what mm-hmm. will happen down the road. But from the business sector, I think we must open, no? Because as I say, we must save not only lives, but livelihoods. And I think with the preparation with Secretary Galvez and Vince Dizon, I think we're ready on that aspect of quarantine. Now, the test kits are all in on the rapid test, the 1.2 million is gradually coming in, and 300 companies are ramping out tests with their employees starting a week ago. And with the LGU, the revelation is Quezon City. We finished the test yesterday with Quezon City, and the numbers were very impressive. Close to 700 at IGG, which means that in the past they had a number of cases, quite a high number of cases, but now they're all well and they have now the antibodies. And the positive cases are only 20. IGG, there were only about 20 out of 4,800 tested. So Mayor Joy has done a pretty good job in controlling, and it's now very minimal from Quezon City, the way I look at it.
But Joy, if you look at the overall pictures, yesterday we saw a record number of new cases, over 500. That's not flattening the curve. That doesn't sound like flattening the curve.
You have capacity just ramping up right now. Mm-hmm. So you have more testing. So you have got all of these backlogs. Earlier on, 1 month ago, I was already saying that there are more cases than what we are reporting. If you look at the death rate in the Philippines way back a month ago, we were as high as 7+% as high as Spain. So definitely we were underreporting the number of cases mm-hmm. because there was not enough PCR capacity. So you are now seeing that most of these tests are coming out. The delay is about 2 weeks. In an earlier webinar that we had, they were explained that these tests were 2 week delayed. So you are testing more and the backlogs are getting unloaded, they're getting reported. So you'll have these ups and downs. So, but I believe that definitely as we move around the LGUs, it's a far cry from what it was before. Mm-hmm. So I believe we're ready. And assuming we are about there, we have to restart the economy or else we will have the biggest disaster where most livelihoods will turn people to even becoming even poorer, that they will not be able to protect themselves with buying enough food and mm-hmm. medicine. So we will have the next problem of real distress in our whole structure of the economy.
And let's talk about these antibody rapid tests. They're looking for antibodies like sort of like the body's army that are triggered when there's a virus. Ms. Janet, I wanted to ask, how many days into the infection will the kids start detecting these antibodies? I guess I'm asking about the specificity and sensitivity of these tests.
There are actually three antibodies. The IgA, that test can be done in a laboratory. The IgM, which will start appearing on day 5 and start speaking up on day 7. And the IgG, which is around in the latter part of the second week of infection. Joey mentioned earlier the percentage of people turning out positive for IgG in Quezon City. What we are seeing is actually the degree of the extent of infection in a population. So if a 20% post-infection can be determined by the rapid tests, Then comes the PCR initiative of Project ARC, which will add 7,000 tests per day capacity to the current capacity of the Department of Health by the end of this month, and another 5,000 capacity by early June. That will be a total of 12,000 tests per day that Project ARC PCR initiative will be adding to the total Philippine capacity. But what we are proposing is not just testing anybody, but a pooled testing among the vulnerable asymptomatics, meaning if you're going to test a million people, that will only transcend to 100,000 tests. It is not sampling, it is actually swabbing everybody and pulling every 10 swabs, testing them as one, because one negative result will actually mean the pool of people swabbed in that sample are all negative. That's part of how we are coping up. Yeah, as Joey earlier mentioned, COVID, the lockdown is not meant to get rid of all the COVID infections, the COVID viruses lurking out there, but the lockdown allowed us to prepare. We are not fully prepared. Nobody is. No country can do that. But we are somehow a lot better than before. Mm-hmm. And we have increased testing capacity. We have more contact tracers now. The DOH still says we need more. People are now aware. Care, medical care is already there. But we have to slowly transition to the new normal while waiting for a vaccine. Because failing to do such and a continuous lockdown will actually result to more non-COVID illnesses. Uh-huh. And the way to move forward is this project that the Joey Concepcion has been supporting. Thank you to our donors who pave way for putting in equipments, automated equipments of that, not only in government hospitals, but in selected private hospitals. And what is important here is that we were able to bring down the cost. And the pooling mechanism that is being suggested by the Philippine Society of Pathologists will actually pave way for one cost of PCR testing, which is roughly between 2,000 to 3,000, will be divided by 10 again. So that will be 200 to 300 pesos. Mm-hmm. We will not be needing a lot of testing kits.
And for Joey, I know that you've been pushing for these rapid antibody rapid tests. We're all for preparation, but I guess the question on a lot of people's minds is this the right kind of preparation? I just wanted to clarify, Joey, are we pushing for the antibody rapid tests for diagnostic or surveillance purposes? Those are two different things.
Yes, let's put it this way. We're using the antibody rapid test for basically screening all our workers.
So that's diagnostic. The
yes, and from that point, we determine who's positive, who are IgG, the IgG, okay? That means they had the virus and they're fine now and they have the antibodies. The IgM, we bring them to the labs to do swab testing. But what Janet was saying now is that I just found this about 2 weeks ago, the idea of pool testing. I think pool testing will make testing for companies using PCR a lot cheaper because once, let's say, in the rapid test, people say that you can get false negatives. Mm-hmm. Okay, how do you check for false negatives? Then you pool, let's say you tested 300 employees using the rapid test. Then you now pool that 300 divided by 10, so that's 30 groups per test kit. So that the 30 there, if anyone that comes out positive, then now you can recheck that maybe you have to go back and recheck that whole group of 30. So there's a way of determining the accuracy of the rapid test kits using this pooled technique. Using the pooled technique.
Is this-